Okay, this morning I want to look at a very familiar passage in the New Testament.
今日咧，Jim想同我哋分享一個喺新約聖經裏邊咧，大家都好熟悉嘅經文喎。It's
also a very beautiful passage.
唔單止大家好熟悉啊，仲係咧呢篇經文咧，仲係好美麗、好美好嘅一個經文嚟嘅。It's
a passage that you're all familiar with, I'm sure.
我相信你哋都係好熟悉呢個經文。
So it's not necessarily that you're going to learn something new, but you're going to be reminded of something that you should have in mind already.
或者咧，唔係一啲新嘅信息啦，但係咧係一個好值得重温嘅、好值得提醒嘅一個信息。But
sometimes don't we need to be reminded of things?
我哋成日都要人哋提醒一啲嘢㗎嘛，係咪？
But sometimes we're like little children and we're not reminded of things, we might go off in this direction or that direction.
因為我哋呢,雖然係大人啦,但係呢,如果冇人哋提醒我哋呢,可能我哋就會好似啲小朋友咁樣呢,就去錯方向喎,中咗第二邊㗎喎。Right
behind Olivia there's a reminder.
咁聖餐呢,都係一個提醒啦。Okay,
that we are reminded the first day of every week of what God did for us.
每個星期嘅主日咧，即係第一日咧，我哋都會神咧藉住聖餐咧去提醒我哋咧，上帝為我哋做咗啲乜嘢。
I mean, this is the greatest event in human history. Would we ever want that to become dim in our minds?
既然咧呢一件事咧係喺人類史上邊最重要嘅一件事，我哋當然唔希望會忘記佢啦。
So, once a month, twice a year, something like that, you know, that's out of the question.
既然咁重要嘅話，冇理由一個月先提醒你一次，或者一年先提醒你兩次啦，咁唔可能啦。Now,
I've got a couple questions for you this morning. Have you ever sat down and read a portion of Scripture, even Scripture that is that you're fairly familiar with, and you kind of walk away and say, I don't really totally understand that.
Even though we're familiar.
Even though it's familiar scripture, is there something there that you feel you don't quite totally understand?
Jim就話啦，想問大家一個問題喎，就係有冇一啲經文咧，你都好熟噶啦，成日都聽到噶啦，不過咧，其實你唔係咁明完全明白咧個經文講乜喎。Ever
happened to you?
有冇發生咧？
Another question, have you ever sat down, you read a scripture, and also really familiar, and you walk away and you say, I just don't understand that at all, it doesn't make any sense to me.
又或者會唔會係有啲經文咧，大家都好熟噶，成日都有人講嘅，但係你係完全唔明白喎，所以咧你睇到嗰度就話，我都唔明噶啦，唔睇啦。That's
happened to me too.
阿Jim有時都會咁樣喎。
It takes me back to my younger days.
佢會諗翻咧自己細個嘅時候或者年青嘅時候。
It takes me back to my high school days. That's a long time ago.
佢就諗起咧佢中學嘅時候喎，咁啊好多年前啦。
When I was going to high school, when I took the normal subjects that everybody would take, but I also took Spanish. I enjoyed Spanish.
咁啊，Jim咧讀中學嘅時候咧，就同大家一樣都係讀嗰啲科目啦。但係佢咧特別咧就揀咗學西班牙文喎，因為佢好有興趣。And
so the summer break came. We had about 3 months break, and I said to myself, I'll have some free time here. Why don't I set a goal for myself and sit down and read the entire New Testament in Spanish, that way I could keep up with the language during the summer.
咁咧放暑假啦，有一年啦，咁個暑假有成3個月咁長喎。於是咧，Jim咧就諗啦，不如我預備一個計劃俾自己啊，俾一個目標自己啊。咁既然我係學緊西班牙文啦，咁樣咧，不如我喺呢一個暑假嗰度咧，我睇新約聖經嘅西班牙版本一次，咁我又可以睇聖經啦，又可以咧去學西班牙文。
So that's exactly what I did, and I finished my goal, and I felt so proud of myself.
咁阿 Jim 咧真係完成到喎，佢覺得咧好自豪。
Of course, I missed most of the message. You know, I was looking at grammar and how words were put together, but the basic message, you know, was up here somewhere.
咁咧誒，但係咧，雖然咁佢完成到啦，但係佢當時咧注重嘅就係學習嗰個西班牙文嘅文法啊。咁反而咧篇經文裏邊嘅意思咧，或者嗰個教訓咧，佢唔係好注重。
And then I will always remember the day when I came to Philippians. Philippians chapter 2, verse 5. And that's what we're going to be looking at today.
今天呢我们就会看腓立比书第二章了。那 Jim 呢就说成日都他特别难忘呢那个看西班牙文新约圣经的经历呢就是当他看到腓立比书第二章的时候。是啦腓立比书第二章的时候。
Now the main English translation back in those days, of course, was King James Version. King James is very, very common. You know, similar to what? Walker Boone?
Mm-hmm.
You know, very, very standard.
當時咧 ，Jim 咧所讀嘅就係嗰個英皇欽定本啊。咁就好似我哋中國人咧成日會睇和合本，入嚟係一個歷史好耐啦，同埋受到人肯定嘅一個譯本嚟嘅。
And in this verse, Paul tells us, at least in the King James Version, you must have the mind of Christ.
咁咧喺英皇欽定本嗰度喺腓立比书二章五节咧，佢就系咁样译嘅喎。佢就系话你要有基督嘅想法，即系你嘅想法或者你嘅心态系要同基督一样。
And I took one look at that and I said, Paul, do you know what you're talking about? That doesn't make any sense at all. How can I have the mind of Christ? Christ created the universe. How can I have a mind like that?
當我 Jim 咧睇到呢個經文嘅時候咧，就諗嚇，保羅，你知唔知你寫緊啲乜嘢啊？我既然耶穌基督係創造宇宙萬物嘅上帝，我點樣會可以同佢有同一個想法咧？
So I was reading a passage that I was familiar with, but I walked away without any comprehension at all. I just did not understand what Paul was talking about there.
咁阿 Jim 咧睇到呢一度嘅時候咧就唔明白啦，但係咧又冇去嘗試去理解佢，只係即係跳過佢，就會覺得我都唔明白，我都唔知你講嘅乜嘢。
And then later on, of course, throughout the years, different translations came out, newer translations. Eventually, the NIV showed up on the scene. And the NIV does not say mind, it says attitude.
後來呢就有越來越多的譯本啦，咁我哋英文成日用的譯本就是 NIV 啦。NIV 呢嗰個翻譯呢就是話，我哋要有同基督一樣的態度。
Well, that makes a little bit more sense. We're supposed to have the same attitude as Christ. You know, if we're Christians, we're supposed to look at other people and regard them in the same way as we would regard ourselves. In the same way as Christ would regard them. The same manner or way of thinking that Christ would have. That makes a little bit more sense.
有呢一個翻譯之後咧，專就覺得容易明白咗啦呢一節經文。我的想法當然我都不知道上帝想什麼想什麼我怎樣有跟基督一樣的想法呢但這裡講的是基督的態度了讓他呢明白到、哦、我開始明白多一點了、就是、基督我們要有跟耶穌基督一樣的態度就是什麼就是當耶穌基督怎樣去對待其他人我們就是要怎樣去對待其他人
And then you know what I did last week when I was preparing this messageI said to myself, I wonder what the Chinese translation is.
咁於是阿 Jim 咧又想明白咧腓立比書二章五節嘅中文翻譯係點喎
？And Olivia and I kind of investigated that, and we did not see mind, we did not see attitude. What did we find? We found heart, right?
中文咧我哋都知道啦，就係咧譯咧，我哋要以基督耶穌嘅心為心啊。佢呢度唔係講態度，唔係講想法，係講個心。
Isn't that a most beautiful way to translate translate this passage. We must have the heart of Christ.
似乎咧呢一個係最美麗嘅翻譯啦，就係唔關乎個想法，唔關乎態度，而係關乎咧個心。
Doesn't that take it one step deeper?
似乎咧由想法到態度到個心。一步一步咧，係更加深入嘅，更加深層次嘅。
Where do our attitudes come from?
我哋嘅態度由邊度而嚟㗎？
You know, when God looks at us, He looks at the heart, not whether we have a lot of hair or what our complexion is or anything like that. He looks at the heart. I think heart here is the most beautiful interpretation of what Paul was actually saying.
既然咧神咧睇一個人係睇佢個心，而唔係睇佢有幾多頭髮，而唔係睇佢外表靚唔靚，咁所以喺呢一度，如果係譯做心嘅話，係更加能夠去表現到保羅咧想表達嘅想法。
Now the Greek does not say heart. You know, it says have this kind of mind, have this kind of mindset, indicating that we are supposed to think in the same way that Christ thinks.Especially in dealing with one another.
在希伯来，在希腊文咧个圣经嘅原文咧，佢强调嘅，佢亦都唔系讲心喎，佢唔系译做心嘅，嗰个意思系大概系一个思想模式咯。我哋应该要咁样去谂嘢咁样。
So I think heart here really covers it very beautifully.
但係咧，如果譯做心嘅話咧，佢所涵蓋嘅意思咧就更加多、更加廣闊啦。
Now in Philippians chapter 2, the verses 1 through 4, we have sort of an introduction to what Paul is going to be saying. And notice one thing here: when the writer comes to something that's especially important to him, he switches from prose to poetry.To a more elegant style, to more elegant language, to put it across in a more beautiful way, and that's what's happening here in this passage.
腓立比書咧第一章第二章咧一至到四節咧，好似係一個引子咁樣，好似一個開頭咁樣，咁先至講第五節佢想講嘅乜係啲乜嘢。另外咧 ，Jim 咧亦都提到啦，就係話咧，當一個作者咧，聖經嘅作者咧。佢係好鄭重要你去留意佢所講嘅嘢嘅時候咧，佢就未必會去用一個評述嘅文字咧去講出嚟，佢會用一個詩歌嗰個題材去講出嚟，令到咧大家會知道呢一件事係嚴肅啲嘅，或者係高雅啲嘅。咁喺呢一度咧就係呢個情況啊。
So this section in the NIV is entitled Imitating Christ's Humility.
在這裏呢， NIV 即英文版呢，它有一個題目給了它喎，就其實和合本都有的，就是說呢，我們要去效法耶穌基督的謙卑。
I mean, that's one way to have the mind or the attitude or the heart of Christ.
要去效法耶穌基督的謙卑咧，係其中一個方法，讓我哋可以帶住耶穌基督的態度，帶住耶穌基督的思想模式，帶住耶穌基督的心咧，去維心啊。
Now verses 1-4 here really deal with the idea of unity. We've talked a lot about unity, how important unity needs to be to us because it's part of the basic nature of God.
腓立比書第二章一至四咧，強調嘅都會係合一啊，喺神之間，即係要有一樣嘅心思、一樣嘅意念，呢一樣係神看重嘅嘢嚟嘅。
Remember, we're created in the image of God, right?
我哋係按神嘅樣式做出嚟噶嘛。
So thinking along the same lines as God thinks would be very natural for somebody created in the image of God.
既然呢我們是按著神的樣式去做，這樣去按著祂的想法、態度和心去，即我們效法這件事，我們要去帶著同樣這些想法、態度和心，這個是很正常的。
I mean, if God can be humble, we can be humble, right?
神既然可以謙卑，我們就可以謙卑，是吧？
Now, can you expect that of an animal?A cat or a dog, can you say, you know, be humble?
你可唔可以去期望一啲動物佢哋可以做到謙卑咧？即係你同一隻貓同一隻狗講你謙虛啲啦，你謙卑啲啦，得唔得咧？
So God created us as completely separate, you see, from the rest of the what, animal world, whatever you want to call it.
首先咧，就係只有人咧係按住神嘅樣式去做嘅，咁所以俾我哋睇到咧，人咧同其他嘅生物咧，佢係唔同嘅。
He gave man responsibility, put man in charge of what he had created, not a lion or a tiger or a cat.
神咧做我哋咧，係俾咗一啲職責俾我哋嘅，咁所以其實人嘅職責咧就唔會去同貓啊、狗啊或者其他動物啊係一樣。
So looking at verses 1-4, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from His love, if any fellowship with the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion.Then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and purpose. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit, but in humility consider others better than yourselves. Each of you should look not only to your own interests, but also to the interests of others.
所以在基督裡若有什麼勸勉，愛心有什麼安慰，聖靈有什麼交通，心中有什麼慈悲憐憫，你們就要意念相同，愛心相同，有一樣的心思，有一樣的意念，使我的喜樂可以滿足。凡事不可結黨，不可貪圖虛浮的榮耀，只要全心謙卑，各人看別人比自己強。各人不要單顧自己的事，也要顧別人的事。
So Paul here is talking about the unity that produces what? Something very positive, namely joy. Unity produces joy.
呢度咧，保羅高舉嘅，保羅所提倡嘅就係要去合一，即係有相同嘅、一樣嘅。咁當我哋合一嘅時候，個結果係乜嘢？個結果就係喜樂。
So in these verses, he's talked about the motivation, okay, for having this unity.
呢度講到就係我哋點解要想要有呢個合一啦，講到個動機啦。
He's talking about the nature of the unity.
亦都講到乜嘢叫做合一。
And then the attitudes we must have in order to maintain this unity.
亦都講到咧，如果我哋想有呢個合一嘅話，我哋應該要抱咩態度？
I mean, with this kind of unity, are we going to have a strong church or a weak church?
如果我哋有咁樣嘅合一嘅話，我哋嘅教會會係剛強啊，定係會軟弱嘅咧？
That's an easy question to answer, isn't it?
咁好容易答啫。
In unity, there's strength. God knows what He's talking about.
合一就會有力量啦，這個我哋都會知道。
So what kind of attitudes we're talking about? Do nothing out of selfish ambition.
这里呢讲到是各人呢不单止要顾自己的事不可以是自私了。
We need to be humble so that we esteem others better than ourselves.
我们要谦卑要看别人比自己强。
Look out for the interests of other people, not just your own interests.
不单止呢是顾自己的事也都要顾其他人的事。
Does that sound like the philosophy of the world around us?
呢一啲教導咧，同呢個世界教導我哋嘅嘢同唔同咧
？Or is it a me first?
定係喺呢個社會所提倡嘅都係以自己為先咧
？Maybe it's a me first attitude, and you're second, or if you're lucky, you're second, maybe you're third.
可能喺呢個世界咧，教導我哋嘅就係以自己為先。跟住以其他人為其次啦。更加慘嘅係咧，就係可能呢個世界教導我哋嘅係以自己為先，就係其他人咧。好彩嘅話，你就係排第二咯。
So then, Paul goes into this very beautiful passage written in poetry, describing the attitude that Christ had, the way Christ thought, his manner of thinking, his mind, his heart.
在腓立比書第二章六至六十一節咧，呢度保羅咧就用一個好似詩歌咁樣嘅體裁咧， 去描述耶穌基督的想法，去描述耶穌基督的心。
So your attitude should be the same as that of Christ Jesus, who, being in very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be grasped.
第五節，你們當以耶穌基督的心為心，他本有神的形象，不以神自己與神同等為強奪的。
But made himself nothing, taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness.
反倒虛己，取了奴僕的形象，成為人的樣式。
And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on a cross.
既有人的樣子，就自己卑微，全心順服，以至於死。
Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name.
所以神將他升為至高，又賜給他那超乎萬名之上的名。
That at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth.
叫一切在天上的、地上的和地底下的，因耶穌基督的名無不屈膝，無不稱耶穌基督為主，使榮耀歸於父神。
And every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father.
無不稱耶穌基督為主，使榮耀歸於父神。
We could almost use this as a meditation in preparation for the Lord's Supper.
單單係呢幾節經文已經足夠我哋去默想去領受聖餐。
So the first thing I think we see here is that Jesus lacked any kind of selfish ambition or conceit.
首先睇完呢段經文我哋知道耶穌佢唔係絕對唔係一個自私，佢唔係為咗要滿足自己慾望或者自己計劃自己想法嘅一個人嘅一個即係上帝嘅一位。
He was in his very nature God.
耶穌本身就是神，他有曬神的本質。
He existed one with God.
他是同神同在的。
Also equal with God.
他是神同神同等的。
I mean, we could turn to John chapter 1, the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verse 1, that tells us the same thing.
我們看《約翰福音》一章一節都是講同樣的內容。
But what does it say here? With all this, still Christ did not consider that as something that he had to hang on to, that he had to grasp.
第六節的意思是講緊，雖然耶穌他是同上帝一樣，他是上帝，但是他沒有將這樣東西，他沒有死攬住呢一樣嘢，佢冇死佢冇唔放開呢一個本質同埋地位。
I just think he could not consider equality with God as something that he had to hang on to in a jealous way, regardless of anything else.
換句説話嚟講，耶穌唔會因為自己同上帝同等，唔會因為自己有呢啲一切嘅身份同地位而。不理其他嘢，而只係持守住呢一樣嘢，佢唔會。
I don't know if we can really understand the depth of that.
其實我哋真係有幾明白呢一節經文講乜嘢咧？
I think that goes a little bit beyond the human mind.
因為係超乎我哋人能夠想像嘅。
But you know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of that rich young man.In Matthew 19.
This passage reminds us that in Matthew 19, there is a young and rich man.
And I say to myself, what a tragedy. We have described that.
So we know that it is a tragedy. That is, for Matthew 19, the rich and rich man described it.
He was determined to retain his riches and his wealth at any cost, regardless of anything else. Completely opposite from the attitude that Christ displayed here.
個悲劇係在於乜嘢啊？就係在於咧呢個富有而年青嘅男子咧，咁佢 佢係好有錢啊！佢咧唔願意放棄自己嘅財富，甚至係永生佢都可以放棄喎。佢只係要自己嘅錢喎。咁呢一個仲唔係悲哀？
So if we look at this more on a human level, you know, do we consider our own standing, our own place in society as something superior to what somebody else might have?
由耶穌基督喺第二章六節嘅佢嘅態度，我哋反思翻我哋自己，我哋有冇因為自己嘅身份地位而睇唔起其他人呢？
Do we consider ourselves more important than other people？
我哋會唔會覺得自己係比人優越嘅個身份地位？我哋會唔會覺得自己先係重要啲嘅，其他人唔係咁重要嘅？
Just imagine a church, let's say a church of 100 people.And you have like four different groups of people, different nationalities, different cultures, different customs, all represented in that church of 100 people.
如果我哋咧就將一個教會啦嚟做一個比喻啦，一個教會假設佢有100人啦，裏邊咧我哋按種族、按文化，我哋分成四類人。
So you have 25 people too proud to associate with another group.Okay, which is too proud to associate with the other group, and so on. What kind of a church would you have?
如果咧，其中有一組人啊，嗰25人覺得自己咧係比較優越嘅，而唔理其他人啊，咁相對地咧，另外一組人又覺得自己又比較優越啲喎，又唔理其他人啊，咁樣呢一個會變成個教會會變成點啊？
Wouldn't that be the weakest church on earth?
咁呢間教會係咪就會成為即係世界上最軟弱嘅、最唔剛強嘅一個教會咧？
And you have one faction struggling and arguing with another faction, and Paul talks about factions in Scripture. That was one of the big problems in the church in those days.
咁你諗下啦，如果呢一班人又唔同嗰班人合一啦，第三班人又唔同第四班人去相處啦，咁樣。咁教會就會有分化啦。保羅咧喺聖經裏邊都有提到教會嘅分化嘅問題。
I mean, we would have dividing walls of hostility. That's what we would have.
喺個教會度咧，可能就大家彼此之間咧就築起一圍牆。
So that kind of thinking, then, that's easy for us to understand. Looking at it at that level.
咁如果我哋即係點樣去理解就係二章六節咧？腓立比書就係二章六節，就用我哋頭先個講法咧，可能就會容易啲理解。
And then what else did the Lord do? He looked out for the interests of other people.
耶穌基督佢會唔會淨係顧自己嘅事，唔顧其他人嘅事咧
？Imagine being equal with God and then.Literally emptying himself of all this power and majesty and glory and becoming flesh.
想唔想象得到一個耶穌基督佢係同上帝同等嘅，但係佢虛己喎，虛己，即係佢放棄曬呢啲一切嘅榮耀同埋位置，去成為人，去成為人嘅樣式。
Did he become a king or a nobleman or somebody high in rank?
佢成為人嘅樣式嚟到呢個世界上，佢係成為一個皇帝啊，成為一個貴族啊，定係成為一個點樣嘅人咧？
How does servant sound?
佢成為一個仆人。
Imagine leaving all this glory and then coming into the world in our incarnation as a servant.
想想這位有上帝的權能、上帝的地位的耶穌基督，他捨棄這些一切成為人都不獨止，還是成為奴僕的樣式。
He came in human likeness.
既有人的樣子。
And as such, he could experience the temptations and the sufferings.That any human being could suffer.
點解要成為人嘅樣子啊？咁樣佢就能夠切身處地咁樣去感受到、體驗到人所經歷嘅一切試探同埋試煉。
I mean, he was divine, he was God, but he was still man.
佢係好神聖嘅，佢仍然係上帝，但係同一時間佢亦都係人。
Now you remember the temptation episode back in Matthew when Satan was tempting Jesus?
記唔記得喺馬太福音裏邊撒但試探引誘耶穌嗰段經文啊？
Of course, Satan came to Jesus when Jesus was in very weak condition.
當時耶穌是禁食了40晝夜，他身體很虛弱。
But if Jesus didn't have the same temptations as we would have, why would Satan even go near him? Didn't Satan see some possibility of actually tempting Christ successfully?
如果耶穌是即如果你話耶穌係神啊嘛，佢唔會俾人唔會俾其他嘢引誘到㗎。如果係咁樣嘅話，撒旦一開始就唔會去引誘佢，反而撒旦係睇到耶穌真係有可能係會被試探、會被引誘過，所以撒旦先去做呢個舉動。
So he truly humbled himself. He truly submitted himself to the will of God, even to the point of going.To the cross, the most terrible kind of death you could imagine in those days.
耶穌基督佢謙卑佢自己，佢唔死攬住嗰個屬於上帝嘅榮耀同埋權能咧。佢謙卑到一個地步，係死喺十字架上邊。十字架係其中一個最殘酷嘅死亡方式。
And the book of Hebrews, Hebrews chapter 5, verse 8, the writer says something worthy of our consideration.
希伯來書第五章第八節咧，作者咧佢講咗一啲個經文咧係好值得我哋去深思嘅。
He's talking about Jesus here, and he says, although he was a son, okay, he learned obedience from what.He suffered. Jesus had to learn obedience.
希伯來書第五章第八節，他雖然為兒子，還是因所受的苦難學了順從。耶穌基督都要去學順從，順從都要學，即對耶穌嚟講都要學。
That's why it struck me as a very unique verse. I mean.You know, we as sons, we learn obedience from our parents, from our fathers and our mothers. You know, that makes sense. But Jesus, being a son, still had to learn obedience from the Father. That's very interesting.
Jim 咧成日都會覺得呢一段經文，呢一節經文咧，希伯來書呢節經文係好特別嘅，因為我哋身為子女嘅，我哋身為人哋嘅仔女，我哋要學順從，呢一個係理所當然。但是耶穌喎，佢係上帝，佢係神獨生子喎，佢都要學順從。
Now, why did Jesus do all this in the first place?
點解耶穌要去做呢啲一切咧
？For his own sake, for his own glory.
係為咗自己，為咗自己嘅榮耀。
Or for the sake of other people.
定係為咗其他人啊
？Maybe even you and me.
定係為咗你同我啊？
Chinese, Filipinos, Germans, you name it.
無論係中國人、菲律賓人，定係咩國籍嘅人，都包含喺裏邊。
So he did it to bear not his reproach, not his sin, but our sin, our reproach.
呢度耶穌點解要死喺十字架上邊啊？為著佢自己嘅罪。
He was looking out for the interests of other people, and we were the other people.
呢一度希伯來書咧第二章呢一度叫我哋唔單止顧自己嘅事，仲要顧人哋嘅事。耶穌所顧人哋嘅事就係我哋嘅罪啦。
Romans chapter 15 puts it very nicely. I think Romans 15 verses 1-3.
我哋一齊揭去羅馬書第十五章第一至到三節。
Doing things for the sake of other people，
就係要去顧及其他人啊。
See, we're talking about here stronger Christians and weaker Christians. What kind of responsibility is necessary there.
我哋呢度睇到，強啲嘅基督徒同埋弱啲嘅基督徒，佢哋係點樣咧？
We who are strong ought to bear with the failings of the weak and not to please ourselves. Each of us should please his neighbor for his good, to build him up. For even Christ did not please himself, but as it is written, the insults of those who insult you have fallen on me.
你們堅固的人應該擔待不堅固人的軟弱，不求自己的喜悅。我們各人務要叫鄰舍喜悅，使他得益處，建立德行。因為基督也不求自己的喜悅，如經上所記，辱罵你人的辱罵都落在我身上。
So are we humble people? Are we looking out for the interests of other people?That's so contrary to the teaching of the world.
我哋係咪謙卑嘅人，係顧及其他人嘅益處咧？哇！呢一個同世界所提倡嘅係好唔同嘅喎。
Hey, that sounds like sacrifice, doesn't it? If you're looking out for the interests of somebody else rather than yourself.All the things I could be doing for myself, but I'm not because I'm interested in this other person or these other people. That sounds like a kind of a self-sacrifice.
或者係要顧及其他人啦嘅益處啦，咁去為著其他人去即係去付出啦。咦，換句説話嚟講，呢個就係犧牲咯。
How can we please God in our lives without some degree of sacrifice?
如果我們不願意去為其他人犧牲的話，我們怎樣去討神的喜悅呢？
Now remember, we call ourselves Christians and we're supposed to think like Christ. Did Christ sacrifice?
既然我們說要以耶穌基督的心為心，我們說自己是基督徒的話，那基督有沒有為其他人犧牲呢？
Is it possible then that we might be called upon to sacrifice in some way?
如果基督是有為其他人犧牲的話，我們又願不願意，或者我們又應不應該去為其他人去犧牲呢？
Or how can we even be consider ourselves Christians if we don't sacrifice in some way?
換句話來說，如果我們不願意去為其他人犧牲的話，我們怎樣還說自己是基督徒呢？
Sacrifice sounds like a very negative word, doesn't it?
犧牲聽上嚟唔係咁好聽喎，好負面嘅喎。
But what happens when we sacrifice for the Lord?
但係如果係為基督而犧牲咧，為上帝而犧牲咧
？The Lord turns around and blesses us in so many ways that when we look back on the whole experience, we don't even consider it as a sacrifice. We consider it more as a blessing and a big step in our spiritual growth.
如果我哋願意係為上帝去犧牲嘅話咧，我哋知道上帝咧會轉頭翻嚟咧就去祝福我哋嘅。當我哋去回想我哋所謂嘅犧牲咧，咁我哋相比神俾我哋嘅祝福，我哋會唔當呢啲係犧牲嚟嘅，唔當係一回事。
So sacrifice can be a great thing in our lives.
所以咧，犧牲咧可以係我哋生命當中咧一個即係一件大嘅事，係一件好嘅事。
And then what else do we find here in this passage?
在腓立比書第二章，我們還看到啲學到啲乜嘢咧？
Okay, Christ sacrificed, right? And then what did God do? How did he respond?
我哋知道咧，耶穌基督佢願意去為人而犧牲啦。咁上帝有啲咩回應俾佢啊？
He was highly exalted by God, of course.
第九節啦，所以神咧將耶穌基督升為至高嘅，又賜給他那超乎萬名之上的名。
Now we read in Scripture that the person who humbles himself will be exalted. He doesn't exalt himself; God exalts him.
喺經文約當中咧，我哋知道咧，當我哋願意謙卑自己嘅時候，上帝咧就會去榮耀我哋，就會去高舉我哋喎。不是我們呢要去自己去爭取什麼榮耀，而是神呢親自呢去將榮耀呢給過我們。
So God gave him the name that's above every name.
神咧赐俾耶稣基督嘅名咧系超乎万名嘅。
I mean that's true right now in present time and in the future. Every knee shall bow.
这个呢不单止是现在式的，将来呢都是这样，就是所有天上地下的无不屈膝向耶稣基督跪拜。
Oh, and what about all authority has been given to me in heaven and earth?
耶稣基督讲过呢，天上地下的一切权柄呢都赐给我了。
You see how tremendous God's blessings were as a result of the obedience and sacrifice of his son?
你見到耶穌基督這位神的獨生子，他當他願意去犧牲自己的時候，天父是怎樣去祝福他呢？
So we can experience the same thing in our lives.
我們同樣可以經歷這些東西。
We need certain ingredients, don't we?
但是我們要有一些元素去幫助我們。
One's humility, we have to submit ourselves to God's desire, to God's word.
如果我們說要謙卑的話，就是呢，我們要去服從呢，神的想法啊，神的意思啊，還有神的說話啊。
I mean, that's what happened to Joy last Sunday. She submitted herself to God's word.
就好像上個星期啦，Joy啊，咁去服從神的話語啦，咁佢就受浸啦。
It takes a certain amount of humility. A humble attitude.
要去行呢一步咧，都系要谦卑自己嘅。
And very, very closely related to that is obedience.
去听神嘅说话啦，即系服从啦。
Okay, and then what else?
仲有
咧？ Sacrifice.
牺牲。
So humility, obedience, sacrifice. These are the basic ingredients of the Christian experience.
谦卑啦，服从啦，牺牲啦，呢啲都系基督徒咧最基本嘅要做嘅嘢。
See, this is what God wants us to do.
神咧对我哋嘅期望，或者佢就系想我哋咁样做。
And that pleases God so much that when we do it.
如果我哋真系咁样做咧，我哋会氹得上帝好开心噶。
His reward is great, and many, many times in ways that we cannot even imagine.
佢俾我哋嘅回報咧，佢俾我哋嘅祝福咧，係會遠超過我哋能夠想像嘅。
So according to the Chinese philosophy, the Chinese way of looking at things, it goes back to the heart, and that's very appropriate.
我哋咧見到咧，中文聖經咧所譯嘅係我哋要以基督嘅心為心。呢一個係一個好好嘅翻譯啦，亦都好好嘅，就好似我哋中國人所理解心嘅嗰樣嘢咯。
So instead of me walking away from this passage once upon a time, really not understanding what I read at all, I think we can walk away with a much deeper and better understanding of just what God expects of His children.
以前咧 ，Jim 咧睇到呢段經文咧，都唔明白、唔理解，或者會跳過佢嘅。但係當我哋去嘗試去理解多啲嘅時候，我哋就會見到天父咧對於佢嘅兒女咧，對於我哋咧有一個咁大嘅期望喎。我哋咧而家咧就將會係紀念到即係用聖餐啦呢個形式啦去紀念到耶穌基督嘅死啦。